So good morning students. Today in this session we are going to learn about triangles and its types. Generally my dear children, what is a triangle? A polygon of three number of sides. A polygon with three number of sides is called triangle. And triangles are classified into two types based on sides and based on angles. So based on sides, triangles are three types. They are, you know, skeleton triangle, isosceles triangle, equilateral triangle. So my dear children, skeleton triangles means a triangle having all unequal sides. A triangle having all the three sides are unequal or unequal sides. For example, roughly A comma B comma C, the triangle. So all the three sides are unequal. A triangle with unequal three sides is called skeleton triangle. And second type is isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle means a triangle having two equal sides. A triangle having two equal sides is called a skeleton triangle. And third one is equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle means a triangle having all the three equal sides. A triangle having all the three equal sides is called as equilateral triangle. And my dear children, so based on sides, three types are there. One is skeleton triangle, isosceles triangle, and equilateral triangle. Now let us discuss based on angles. Based on angles, the triangles are classified as follows. Acute angle triangle, right angle triangle, and obtuse angle triangle. So what is acute angle triangle? Acute angle triangle means what? A triangle each of whose angle measures less than 90 degrees. Is called acute angle triangle. This is an example. A triangle measures whose angle is less than 90 degrees is called acute angle triangle. And second one is right angle triangle. Right angle triangle means, my children, a triangle whose one angle measures 90 degrees. So for example, see, this is 90 degrees. This is called right angled triangle. For example, O A B. So this is right angled triangle because one angle measures 90 degrees. And next, right angled triangle, already you learned, no? Next one, obtuse angle. So obtuse angle, my dear children, you see, observe here, obtuse angle means a triangle whose measures less than 180 degrees but more than 90 degrees. Whose angle measures less than 180 degrees but more than 90 degrees is called, you know, obtuse angle triangle. triangle. Obtuse angle, triangle. Okay, whose measures, whose angle measures more than 90 degrees but less than 90 degrees called obtuse angle. Next, straight angle. What is the straight angle? Straight angle. Straight angle. So what is mean by straight angle? You know, straight angle, whose angle is measures 180 degrees. 180 degrees is called as straight angle. 180 degrees is called as straight. Straight angle is called, is measures 180 degrees. This is nothing but, we can draw like this, straight angle. So this is 180 degrees. This is 180 degrees. Straight angle is 180 degrees is called straight angle. And the next one is, you know, straight angle learnt. And of course, one more important thing is reflex angle. What is called reflex angle? For example, see, reflex angle means what? The angles between 180 and 360 degrees. 180 and 360 degrees is called reflex angle. Okay, 180 and 360 degrees called reflex angle. Okay, and some more important thing is what are parallel lines and intersecting lines and perpendicular lines. So what are intersecting lines? Intersecting lines means what? Intersecting means what, my dear children? If two lines have a common point, they are called intersecting lines. For example, simple here. For example, children, okay, intersecting is what? Two lines have common point. Or else you draw like this. Two lines having a common point, they are called as intersecting lines. Intersecting lines. If two lines having common point, for example, see, you can take L and M. These are two lines having common point, they meet at O. They are called as intersecting lines. If two lines having common point, they are called as intersecting lines. And next one, what are called parallel lines? Parallel lines means what, my dear children? Parallel lines. For example, see, if two lines on a plane do not intersect each other, at any point, they are called as parallel lines. So, for example, see, we can draw like this, parallel lines, L and M. So, these two lines are parallel lines because they do not intersect at any point. They do not intersect at any point. These are called L and M are two parallel lines because they do not meet at any point are called parallel lines. Okay. And last one is perpendicular lines. What are perpendicular lines? For example, see, if two lines intersect each other at right angle, if two lines intersect each other at right angles, then the lines are perpendicular lines. How right angles here? So, for example, see, my dear children, perpendicular. So, this is perpendicular lines. Okay, if two lines intersect at one point, perpendicular lines. And one angle measures compulsory 90 degrees. Okay, this is called perpendicular lines. Okay, this is called perpendicular lines. If two lines intersect at one point are called perpendicular lines, or you can draw this also. This is also a perpendicular lines. Okay, L, M. These are perpendicular lines. If two lines intersect at one point, they are called perpendicular lines. So, thank you, children. I think everybody understood. Thank you. Have a nice day.